Hi, and welcome back to the Saveitforparts channel. Normally on this channel, I build strange contraptions out of recycled junk. I don't often put a lot of technical info or scientific theory into my designs. They're largely just cobbled together from spare parts and things I dumpster dived. However, sometimes it's cool to consider the scientific background of some of these inventions and devices. A great place to see the evolution of science and technology is the Musée d'Art et Métiers in Paris, France. While the literal translation is Museum of Arts and Crafts, there are fewer popsicle sticks and pipe cleaners than you might expect from the name. It's more like a science museum, if science mostly stopped around 1900. There are a few stray devices from the 20th century, but Paris apparently has another science museum out in the suburbs for all the modern stuff. This leaves the Musée d'Art et Métiers looking a little bit like a steampunk museum. Half the stuff is made of brass and wood with exposed gears, or it looks like props from a low-budget sci-fi movie. It's actually really awesome. The museum was founded in 1794 in a deserted monastery, and the exhibits snake through the building on multiple levels. Apparently one of its most popular early artifacts was a talking, flapping, pooping mechanical duck, although sadly this no longer exists. When you first enter the museum, it's a little hard to tell how big it is. You're first directed into a narrow attic at the top of the building, showcasing early clocks, telescopes, and other measuring instruments. A few stray computers and robots have snuck in here, but there's really nothing much newer than the 1960s. Next came the materials gallery, showing off the early stages of mass production and the Industrial Revolution. In the middle of the museum, we were entertained to find some actual arts and crafts. This room had interactive projects for school groups and creations of local kids. As we reached the construction gallery, we started to realize just how large this museum actually is. What was going to be a quick trip soon became nearly a full day. There were just so many cool models and displays to check out. Apparently, a lot of these models were designed as teaching aids for the Associated Technical School. In several parts of the building, we noticed narrow-gauge railroad tracks embedded in the floor. There's not much on-site information about this, it's kind of a mystery, so I had to do some online research. It turns out that the tracks were used to move around displays with small hand-pushed rail carts. Professors in the technical school could request certain displays or models be brought from the museum into their classrooms. Apparently this was somehow less disruptive than making the students walk through the museum. Sadly, the tracks are no longer in use, and they're blocked or removed in several places. We did see one of the original push cars. Interestingly, it only had flanged wheels on one side. I'm not quite sure why, maybe it was to negotiate tight curves on the track. Continuing through the communication gallery, we saw some interesting printing presses, cameras, and electronic gizmos. A few more computers had snuck in here, but fortunately, nothing really modern. The energy gallery really brought out the steampunk feel of the museum. As the display explains, these relatively small steam engines were perfect for use in your home or apartment. The mechanics gallery was one of the smallest wings, but probably the most packed full. Many of these displays and models were obviously teaching aids, demonstrating various forces, gearing, machine tools, etc. Finally, the transportation gallery included one of the first powered aircraft, kind of based on a bat design. It also had the first powered car, run by a steam engine. Sadly, a few of the other galleries seemed to be closed for renovation, or we just missed the open hours, so we didn't get to see the pendulum or the Statue of Liberty model. I would highly recommend this museum for anyone who's visiting Paris. Even if you aren't excited about science and technology, the sheer amount and variety of old stuff means there's something for everyone. And if you are into inventions and mechanical gadgets, this collection is incredibly cool and inspirational. It also doesn't hurt if you like the steampunk aesthetic. I would like to mention that this is not a sponsored video, and I'm not getting any kickbacks from the museum. I just think it was really awesome, and I think everyone should check it out. Thanks for watching. We'll try to get back to some of my own half-baked inventions in upcoming videos, so stay tuned for those.